How big is this for you?
Big. I mean, I didn't do it all these years for nothing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's really gratifying to see.
And what was the message you just left those guys with? I know some of the off the field things are really important to you, like eye contact. Those guys who weren't looking at you in the huddle. Those are kind of things that you can tell them that maybe their high school coaches don't, right?
Or the parents.
Yeah. What is the importance of that message?
Well, it gives me a platform. You know, I'm old. They see the gray hair. It gives me a platform. You know, I tell them, you know, when they're talking to me, you're going to get my eyes and ears. So, to be fair, when I'm talking to you, you give me your eyes and ears.
Yeah.
They need to learn that.
Right.
Listen to what I'm saying. Don't be thinking about something else.
Yeah.
Focus on what I'm saying.
Right.
And I think I try to teach my children the same thing. I try to do that for people. I listen to what they say. And I focus on what they're saying before. I don't focus on my answer. I focus on what they're saying.
What's something you wish you told college football players earlier?
Oh, my goodness. You know, I wasn't any different than a player as a coach. I got better. I tried to get better every year. I don't think people realize that that coaches are like players. You know, we're seeking improvement all the time. And I encourage them to look under every stone. And I tried to do the same thing as a coach. I was constantly trying. I'm still doing it. I'm trying to improve myself every day.
LSU football, Brian Kelly, what he's done in his first year and what he can do in his second year?
Well, we know what he did the first year. I don't know what he's going to do the second year. But history is our greatest teacher, and he has had success everywhere he's ever been. I have a lot of respect for him as a football coach. I don't know him personally, but I admire what he's accomplished in his life. And it was certainly a good season, exciting season. I don't think the West was quite what it normally is, and everything. It was, you know, and there's some good things happened for LSU, to win championships, good things have to happen for you. But, you know, it's not a sprint, it's a long distance run. So I wish him the very best, though. I mean, you know, I love LSU, and I want him to do well, and I want him to do well.
And they proved that it was a marathon after the opening game loss last season and what they were able to
do. And you know, they did well. I don't want to take anything away from the success they had, but I thought they did very well, and I'm pulling for them to do even better this year. I think they can too.
What do you know about the guys on the O-line, D-line staff over there and how important that element to their game is? Because obviously those guys, as you've talked about, as many talk about, don't get as much ink as the quarterbacks and the receivers, you know?
Yeah. Well, the defensive coordinator is a guy I've been associated with a long time, a guy named Matt House.
Yeah.
And Matt is a really, really good football coach. He's as knowledgeable as anybody's defensive coordinator. And on top of that, a tremendous person, okay? And then the defensive line coach, Jimmy Lindsay, I have been associated with and working with for about 4 years. I think Jimmy's a hard-working, good guy, and I think he'll do a good job for him. I think he'll put a good product on the field. They just hired an analyst for him, Ken J. Cotton, who is really a good young football. I called Matt and told him, I said, you know, that was a heck of a hire. So I think they're in good shape there. And of course, Matt works with the linebackers. I know JJ, the outside linebacker coach. He's a veteran guy. He was a coordinator in the SEC.
Yep.
I think they got a nice staff put together, and probably stronger and more together, vision-wise, than they were this time last year. I look for them to improve and grow, and And they got some good players. They get some very good players. So I look for them to have a good, typical LSU defense.
I see the Alabama shorts. Talk to me about Saban and the SEC.
Yeah, but you know me, if it's free, give me three, you know. If you'd have been here the day before yesterday, I had Auburn shorts on. Yeah, I don't buy shorts. People give me shorts, okay? Yeah, Coach Saban, I don't want to get started because I could talk all day.
Right.
You know, but we have a 23-year background together, and he's been great to me. And I've been working for him since the day I met him in 2000. I might not have been full-time, but I've been working for him, except for 16 and 17. When I went back to LSU with Coach Ogeron, I didn't work for him then. We didn't even speak. But I have tremendous admiration for the man. And I would say this to you, I have that admiration for him on the field, of course, like a lot of people do. But I have that same admiration for him off the field because I know him to be a tremendous human being.
What do you think about the new SEC schedule format?
I don't know. I'm paying attention to it. It's just 1 year, isn't it? I don't worry about something that's going to last 1 year. Yeah. I mean, it's going to be 1 year. So I don't know. I didn't spend any time looking at it. Just glanced at it. It's a year. Now, when it's more than a year, you need to really pay attention to it. But it's a year thing until they get. I wasn't for the expansion of the playoffs. I know I'm probably in. And the only reason I'm not is I coached 55 years, and I coached players, and I saw guys during the course of a season. And you say, well, the NFL plays that long, but the NFL's different too now. In this, those are men, that's a job, and they don't practice like colleges do. The colleges are gonna have to make adjustments in practice. Colleges work very hard during the season, and you can't afford to do some of the things. As the season extends, you've got to adjust yourself that way. And these guys could do that. These head coaches in the SEC, they'll do that. But I don't like it. I think a lot of times on the bottom end, you get bad games. Who wants a bad game? But anyways, they didn't call me and ask me, so.
Kevin mentioned Will Campbell at LSU and the opportunity he got his freshman year. Anybody stand out from this camp as of recent that have gone on to, you know, play college football at LSU or in the SEC?
You know, we don't get a lot of – we did early on. We used to get a lot of prospects here. But since the colleges have the camps that they have, the one-day camps, which are, a lot of kids that are college prospects – go to those camps,
right.
Which is fine.
Yeah.
I did that for years. You know, I started my first camp was for Paul Dietzel in the 70s at South Carolina. So I've been camping for a long time, to be honest with you. Their mission is a different mission than the camp here. So this is a camp that could care less if you're a no star or a five star.
Mm-hmm.
We don't recruit here. It's all about helping kids with fundamentals of the game. Another way of saying it, yeah.
What is the last thing that you can leave as far as fundamentals, tackling, blocking, those types of things with these guys before they do leave, five star or no star?
Well, the only thing I can answer that with you is that we have some objectives over here on this field, and their eyes, explosion out of the hips, legs, and lower back, hands, footwork, tackling, which we think is a really important skill, and we refer to it as safe and effective tackling, okay? And then a work ethic that we hope will be an example to them, and their work ethic is so important for them now when they go back, when they get out of school. Work ethic is big to us, and so we're constantly telling them, and you asked me what I said to them this morning. I talked to him about focus on improvement. That pursuit drill yesterday looked horrible, horrible. The focus on attention to detail, attention to improvement, reflected it so much today, I could not believe it myself. And they saw it. because they put that attention to detail and attention to focusing on improvement, not just a rep, but focus on every rep. So, yeah, we try to, I mean, I'd like to be able to teach them things like that too. I didn't go into coaching just to teach blocking and tackling, you know what I mean? I'd like to be helpful to them and helpful to their parents and their coaches and all that kind of stuff.
Do you got LSU Alabama this year?
I don't watch a game. I never watch a game.
Serious?
Never. I watch playbacks. Watching the game is not good for my health. The year that they played the national championship, my wife and I was working at a facility in Atlanta. We went to a movie. We went to see War Horse. You remember that movie? We went to see War Horse. And we got out of the movie, and the game wasn't quite over. And we went, I told her, I don't want to listen to the radio. I don't hear nothing until the game's over. I get the score, and then I get the box score, and I look at the first downs, and I look at it. And then I watch the playbacks and everything. I don't watch a game. I haven't watched a game in years and years and years. I got too much investment. I mean, you know, I can't win. I can't lose. Georgia and Alabama is hard for me because I work at Georgia also, you know, and that's really hard for me because I'm involved with both of those programs. But I'm not just a fan, you know what I mean? I got blood running in the halls over there, you know, at all those places. So I won't be watching it. When they play that night, just remember, I ain't going to be watching it. You say, Pete Jenkins ain't watching that game.
I will remember that. Thank you
okay.
so much, my
yes,
friend.
Sir. Yes,
appreciate
sir.
Appreciate it. Pleasure to meet you.
Yeah.